How are you doing, A2 class? I'm Lewis.
I'm Brandon.
And today we're going to explain if there are g-forces acting upon this scale model.
And if it's possible to prove that with a mathematical equation.
Wow, what does that mean?
Half the portion behind the roller coaster. Basically, you take the potential energy and it equals out to kinetic energy because we're measuring it from the top of the track to the bottom of the track.
What was the first thing I said to you?
The equation that we used here is UG equals K. UG is potential energy, K is kinetic energy. Right here is where the car picks up the potential energy. And right here releases that potential energy, making kinetic energy. Now, when it's released here, the whole purpose of our lab is to find out if there's actually G-forces acting upon this.
Okay, so UG, the potential energy, for example, would be like this ball. Up here is where the coaster is at when it's at its peak potential, and then once I drop it. So when I drop the ball, the potential energy is released and turned into kinetic energy, just like this.
How would you know that?
And when you do all the algebra and math, you come up with velocity equals 4.00 meters per second. That's what we're trying to find. And then we move over to g-force. The reason why we figured out velocity is so we can plug in for g squared.
So, our thesis is we have to figure out if there's g-forces acting upon this model coaster. Now, g-force is basically just a measurement of acceleration that indirectly causes weight. Now, in order to find the g-force, you have to take your velocity.
You know your velocity,
you divide it by your radius, and then you divide it by gravity, which is 9.8. And that's how you get your g-force, which ends up being 4 g's that acts upon the coaster. Now off to Brandon.
And then so, using our expert math skills, we calculated that the velocity, in fact, is 4 meters a second of this roller coaster car. I'm just like, oh. Meters a second, ladies and gentlemen.
Very bad feeling.
Using the g-force equation, we calculated that the track itself produces 4 g's. However, since we naturally feel 1 g because of due to gravity, and you have to add on to that. So in reality, this, if you were to ride this roller coaster, you would experience 5 G's. Now, we've proven that the size of a roller coaster doesn't matter. Even little model roller coasters can produce G-force. Thank you.
You're a smart motherfucker, that's right.